Have you ever seen one of these collapsible containers? I mean, how hard could it be to make one of these things? Turns out, it's really hard to make one of these collapsible silicone containers.
My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Okay, we have a two-part mold that I 3D printed. This is an SLA part. And we are gonna make a silicone part. This goes in here, and we'll place a weight in here, and there's some holes in here so the excess silicone can come out. And then there's a piece of tape that's been placed on here so that I can actually take the two pieces apart afterwards. You can also do this with a suction cup or something down here in the middle, but I don't have a suction cup. So we're just gonna use a piece of tape and hope that that works for the two pieces to come apart. So let's go ahead and mix up some silicone and get it in here and make this part.
I'm gonna use silicone inks, standard Tin Cure 1040 silicone, and add a little bit of colorant to the silicone for the first attempt. I'm gonna vacuum degas the silicone so that there's no air bubbles in the silicone, so that when we pour it inside the mold, we don't have any trapped air bubbles, because we wanna get a really nice part. Let's take it out of the vacuum chamber and we'll start to pour it inside the mold in between the two parts. So I want the silicone to go everywhere. And there's actually a little groove or a ridge around the top, and that's why you see me fill the silicone in there, because I want to make sure that the silicone is filled in there really good. And we'll add some weight. The mold is set up to stop at a certain distance, so the weight is just to speed up the removal of the excess silicone. And of course, taking the mold apart is proving much more difficult than I anticipated. I'm gonna add some blocks here that I'm gonna hot glue. That's gonna give me something to grip onto to pull the two halves of the mold apart.
Not too bad. Doesn't wanna collapse.
I made a lot of molds on this project to get one to actually work. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the differences between the molds and the process that I went through and the changes that I made to the molds. So this is a cross-section of the final part. Now, you're probably wondering why I made all these different molds. So in the beginning, I just was using a different durometer of silicone, thinking I could solve the problem. But it turns out that this is a much deeper issue and much more difficult to solve. I spent a fair amount of time with this surface right here that I'm marking out, getting this angle correct so that the container would collapse. Also spent a fair amount of time figuring out what that angle should be, and of course that angle is dependent on the thickness of the living hinge. So right here in this area, this is probably the most critical part of making a collapsible container, is the distance in between here. And it's very thin. We're talking about like 0.2 millimeters. And the other thing, of course, is the wall thickness of the part itself. You want that to be strong enough so that it doesn't buckle. Here you can see all the different parts that I made and different attempts with different durometers of silicone and different colors, and ultimately the client wants a translucent part. So I also used my vibration table to help the silicone come out of in between the two molds with a little bit of weight on top of it. This really helped the silicone kind of flow out of the holes. I'm gonna demold the part here quite early. It's only been in the mold for about 3 hours, so it is holding its shape, but it is not fully cured. Then I go through and I trim up the part, just using a little pair of cuticle scissors to trim off the excess so that I can place the part inside of the frame. Now I'll place the part in the collapsed position.
All right, so I let it cure. I took it out of the mold early, and I let it cure. And now it stays up, basically, and it can collapse, and it can stay up in the collapse position, correct. It has a small tear in it or whatever, but it needs to be remade. But post-curing it in the collapsed state is the key for making this. So finally.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.